And now we will learn how to use one of the most important tools in QuickBooks, using the journal report. The journal report is one of the most important reports that you will need to be able to manage your QuickBooks file. It's the only report that shows every transaction since the beginning of the file, regardless of what transaction type it is. It's the only report that shows every transaction in the order in which it was entered into the computer, regardless of date. You could also add a column to show the date that the transaction was actually entered as compared to the date that the transaction actually happened. The journal is helpful because if you are inputting many different types of transactions in one session, the journal is the only report that can tell you where you left off. For example, if you're putting in bank transactions and credit card transactions from different banks and different credit cards, and you're not doing them in any particular order, only the journal will show you the order in which every single transaction was entered into the computer, regardless of type. It's also helpful because it's the only report that can help you find a date mistake. And that's because it shows everything in order entered, not date order. From the main menu, click Reports, Accountant and Taxes, Journal. Don't worry about this pop-up. You can just click the Don't Bother Me box and then click OK. Now, notice the journal opens with the date range from June 1 to June 28. That's because automatically, meaning by default, the date range is always this month to date. And because I am recording this video during June of 2016, it opens from the beginning of June 2016 until today. The proper way to see the journal is to click the date pull-down arrow, scroll all the way up, and click All. This way you're asking the journal to show you every transaction regardless of date. Notice the first transaction we had at the beginning of this video series was dated July 1, and it was a deposit to Chase Bank. Then the next one was dated July 2, a deposit to T&M Bank, and so on. If we scroll all the way down, we get the most recently entered transactions in the most recently viewed videos. Notice we only have 15 transactions that have been entered into this QuickBooks file. If you scroll all the way up and you look at the column headings, you notice that you have the date of the transaction, the number of the source document, you have the accounts that changed, and the money amounts for each transaction on each line. The column all the way to the left is transaction number. That's a number that can never be changed once any transaction has been recorded in this QuickBooks file. Notice it's in numeric order, so this deposit on July 1 was the first transaction in the file. This deposit on July 5th was the fifth transaction in this file, and so on. If we scroll down, you could see the approximate date and transaction number that we started putting in checks instead of deposits. And if you scroll all the way down, you can see the most recently entered transaction. In order to prove to you that the journal will always show the transactions in the order in which they were entered, we can change the date on one of the transactions and see that it still stays in the same place. Look, not July 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, transaction 10, 11, 12, 14, 15. 13 is missing, and we'll discuss why in the next video. But notice it's seems like it's in date order, but it's really in transaction number order. Now, I want to change something about this T&M transaction. So I know that this is dated July 11th in the TNM register. I'm going to open up the TNM register, click on this very transaction, and I'm going to change the date to July 1. Now when I what's going to happen when I click record? Well, because the register is currently showing in date order, as soon as I record the date change, this transaction is going to jump to the top. But in the journal, it's going to stay in the very same position. So let me go ahead and click record. Click yes for the change. Now notice the TNM bank fees for $20 has jumped to the top of the TNM register because this register is currently showing the transactions in date order. But when I look at the journal, I see that transaction number 12, which is the $20 TNM bank fees, even though it's dated July 1, it's still in the same position in the order of the transactions. July 9, July 10, July 1, July 12, because the transaction number is the order in which the transactions are listed regardless. I guess we better change back our little experiment. Open the TNM register, click on the date, click in the calendar box, and change it back to July 11, click record, click yes, and in the register, while the register is showing order entered, it still jumps back to its position, but notice the journal hasn't changed at all. All it did was update the change in the date. So if you're putting in a lot of transactions and you don't know where you left off, open the journal. If you want to see the order in which they were really entered or find every possible transaction, regardless of which register it was entered in, use the journal. There is one more thing that you can do with the journal to make it more helpful. You can add a column for date entered modified, so that this way you will not only see every transaction in order entered, but there will be a special column just for the date that it was actually put in to QuickBooks. While the journal is still open, go to the top left and click Customize Report. Notice there are four tabs. Usually it will already open with the Display tab selected. In the bottom of the Display tab section, there's a scroll bar, and in this box that's labeled Columns, click a check mark next to these words, Entered Last Modified. Make sure you place a check mark and the check mark stays there. Entered Last Modified. Click OK. Now you have added this column to the journal. So for example, this transaction is dated July 10, but it was actually entered into QuickBooks on June 27. That's something that will also be helpful to you. Now that the journal looks the way you need it to look, go to the top left and click View, Add Journal to the icon bar. Then click OK, and now there's a shortcut. Because you added the shortcut after you added the column, that means when you open it from the icon bar, the column that you need, the column that you added, will still be here.